telecommunications section. Telegram machines. The idea for the electric telegraph was not thought up in a scientific laboratory, but on the deck of a sailing ship called the Scully, in the middle of the Atlantic Ocean. The inventor was Samuel Finley Breeze Morse, and in 1832, he was one of the most famous artists in the United States. In 1837, he developed his telegraph idea enough to test it. Morse strung 1,700 feet of wire around his room at New York University, where he taught. It worked. His signals traveled from one end of the wire to the other. Therefore, the telegraph system used lines similar to telephone lines, but did not use pitch. It was used to send messages from one place to another by using electronic on or off signals similar to the dots and dashes used in the Morse code. In Nigeria, the telegraph was for many years the fastest means of sending and receiving important messages aside the telephone. Teleprinter T100. A teleprinter is an electromechanical typewriter that is used to communicate typed messages from point to point and point to multipoint, a variety of communication channels that range from a simple electrical connection such as a pair of wires to the use of radio and microwave as a transmission medium. They could also serve as a command line interface to early mainframe computers and mini computers, sending typed data to the computer with or without printed outputs, and printing the response from the computer. The teleprinter consists of a typewriter-like keyboard and a printer, powered by an electric motor. The two devices are coupled to the motor by clutches that are brought into operation automatically when required. A message is sent by typing on the keyboard. The teleprinter has evolved through a series of inventions by a number of engineers, including Royal Earl House, David Edward Hughes, Emil Badeau, Donald Murray, Charles Crumb, Edward Kleinschmidt, and Frederick G. Creed between 1846 and 1924. Page teleprinter. Of Britain, Mr. Creed introduced the first page printing teleprinter in 1927. Earlier teleprinters used the 5-bit Badeau code, also known as ITA2. Now, this limited the character set to 32 codes. One has to use a Figgs shift key to type numbers and special characters. Special versions of teleprinters had Figgs character for specific applications, such as weather symbols or weather reports. Print quality was poor by modern standards. The Badeau code was used asynchronously with start and stop bits. The asynchronous code design was intimately linked with the start-stop electromechanical design of teleprinters. Example of this is the 5-level Badeau code page printer. Morse teleprinter instrument. Morse teleprinter instrument, or code, is a character encoding that was devised in 1835 by Samuel F.B. Morse, the creator of the electric telegraph. Currently, the most popular use of Morse code is by amateur radio operators, although it is no longer a requirement for amateur licensing in many countries. In the professional field, pilots and air traffic controllers are usually familiar with Morse code and require a basic understanding. Teleprinter Siemens in-house key. Siemens teleprinter model 100 Sir 1 was created in early 1960s and was used for telex service. This is an exchange system such as telex and TWX. These created a real-time circuit between two machines, so that anything typed on one machine appeared at the other end immediately. USA and UK systems had actual telephone dials. German systems did dialing via the keyboard. Teleprinter T1000. Lorenz, the Siemens company, was one of the inventors of the German Telex network. They started production of teleprinters at the end of the 1920s. Siemens T1000 was created and was in use from 1976 to 1985. It has 5-level Baudot code page printer speed, 50 to 100 board plastic type wheel printing mechanism. The first fully electronic teleprinter available as ASR, KSR or RO version. There was also the PMO's logic controlled machine from the peak of the Telex era. Teleprinter T1000S. This was an improved version of the model T1000 Siemens. T1000S was in use between 1985 and 1990. It also has a 5-level Baudot code page printer with speed of 50 to 100 board and has a plastic type wheel printing mechanism. It is available also with monitor and disk memory. Teleprinter T1200BS. This Siemens T1200 was in use between 1986 and 1991. It also has 5-level Baudot code page printer of between speed 50 to 100 board. It has a matrix printer and electronic memory. It is the last ever produced teleprinter model by Siemens. These machines were built in a time where Telefax already replaced the Telex service. It is available in two main versions. Analog section. Copper weld. Alexander Graham Bell invented the telephone over 100 years ago. At first, the telephone lines were separate lines that connected pairs of telephones. The telephone lines were zinc-grounded wires made of iron or steel. Some wires were galvanized for corrosion resistance. But corrosion problems were nevertheless prevalent. The lines were single-grounded wires and they were inherently noisy. Phosphor bronze wires and compound copper steel wires were made in an attempt to decrease the noise in the lines. The benefits of using copper conducting wires were known, but the technology was not available to make a copper wire strong enough for an overhead wire. Then, in 1877, Thomas Doolittle developed the process for hard-drawn copper wire in the Naugatuck Valley of Connecticut. He had soft, annealed copper wire drawn through a series of dies in order to increase its tensile strength. The hard-drawn copper wire was strong enough for overhead wires, and copper took over the telephone wire market. In 1884, an experimental long-distance telephone line made of copper was set up between Boston and New York. Thus, copper weld wire has been utilized and relied upon for years as a strong, non-rusting, efficient grounding conductor, which combines the strength of steel with the conductivity and corrosion resistance of copper. These properties make it ideal for many utility, telecommunication, and general industry applications. Telephone cable. A telephone cable is called Category 3 or Cat 3. It has 4 wires inside of the cable steel. 2 are used for data, 1 for power and 1 for ground. Though Alexander Graham Bell invented the telephone over 100 years ago, the first telephone cable line was set up in Boston in 1877. It connected the home of Charles Williams Jr. and Somerville M.A. with his Boston office. In Nigeria, the lines came into existence with the arrival of the telephone, especially in the homes and offices of the then colonial offices. In most cases, 2 copper wires, tape and ring, for each telephone line run from a home to a local telephone exchange. The wires between the junction box and the exchange are known as a local loop, and the network of wires going to an exchange, the access network. Paper core unit paper insulated. Telephone cables were employed for aerial, underwater and underground use in 1879. Early cables were single grounded wires followed by metallic circuit lines after their development. However, there was need for improvement. This led to the development of paper insulated dry core cable, which served as conductor. The dry core cables were successful because the lead tin alloy sheeting now provided adequate waterproofing. By 1891, dry core paper insulated cables was the standard. The size of the conductor and the electrostatic capacity requirements were further reduced and greatly decreased the noise in the lines. By the late 1890s, telephone and electric power cables were laid underground in conduits made of creosoted wood. And by 1891, dry core paper insulated cable was the standard. The size of the conductor and electrostatic capacity requirements were further reduced and greatly decreased the noise in the lines. Binding wire. This is a tapered fiber optic distribution cable that includes a plurality of drop cables having at least one predetermined breakout location where a drop cable is withdrawn from the tapered distribution cable. The drop cables are bound together to form the tapered fiber optic distribution cable by bounding members or helical winding. Each drop cable contains a plurality of optical fibers which may be reconnectorized according to a user's preferences. It was invented by Brian Herbst and assigned to AFL Telecommunications, LLC. The filing in U.S. was on August 8, 2006. The patent number is 7590320. Clipper. A circuit or device that limits the instantaneous output signal amplitude to a predetermined maximum value, regardless of the amplitude of the input signal. This was introduced in the 1950s. Universal closure, UC. A UC is a type of closure for tightening optic fiber cables and for splicing of cables. It has been in use from 1993 to date. UC is a type of closure for tightening optic fiber cables and for splicing of cables. Underground cable roller. Underground cable roller came into use in the early 20th century and it is used for installation of underground power cable or communication cables. There are different types of rollers for installation of communication or power cable in the trench, some of which are trench roller, twin link corner roller, trench feed roller set, manhole quadrant roller, duct entry rollers, and cable duct protection. It is advisable that cable rollers should always be used when pulling cables. Cable clamp. In the early 1900s, cable clamps were used to make cable installations easier, and they provide protection from the damage that high winds inflict upon improperly fastened cables. Damage that may lead to increased deflection due to mechanical stress. Cable jack. To understand a cable jack, first of all, explain a telecom cable, as cables primarily designed for the interconnection of telephone equipment which is installed indoors. Telecom UTP cables are terminated with standard connectors as punched down. Therefore, a cable jack can be explained as a telephone cable plug that has a type of male connector used to connect a telephone to the telephone wiring in a home or business, and in turn to a local telephone network. It is inserted into its female counterpart, a telephone jack, commonly affixed to a wall or baseboard. It is a connector of outgoing lines and bulk circuits. Modern telephone cable jack were introduced in 1985. B. Cable jacks. Cable jacks were used to lift, support, and stabilize low and high voltage cable drums to enable efficient cable laying and pulling for low and high voltage cables. This includes hydraulic cable jacks, screw cable jacks, and cable jack towers. for lifting cable drums, weights up to 30 tons. Standard hydraulic cable drum. Jacks lift 3-ton, 6-ton, and 10-ton weight. Registered jack were introduced by the Bell System under a 1976 FCC order, ending the use of protective couplers provided exclusively by the telephone company. The new modular jack replaced earlier bulkier connectors. Cable rollers. This is used to release the telecommunication cable and the power cable. It has been in use since the early 1900s. Cable bearer. These are among the different types of cable bearers used from the early 1900s, among which are A. Bracket cable bearer. A bracket cable bearer affixed to the cable bearer wall tie by means of the pins locking cable bearer. They are made of galvanized cast iron and are designed to support all types of multi-core cables and closure. Cable bearer wall tie. Wall tie is used for supporting cables in manholes and joint boxes. They are fixed to the wall of the chamber or joint box to accommodate the bracket cable bearers. Pin locking cable bearers are used to fix bracket cable bearers to cable bearer wall ties. 3-meter better bird. This is used in the buried compound compression closure method, which forces the encapsulant up the cable core to stop water ingress. The product is simple to install, comes with a spacer web and plastic wrap, and is used to hold and force the encapsulant. The product, which came into use in the 1980s, is deferred, is offered in different sizes to cover various cable ranges and can be easily extended and bricked. Hale Split Splice Case. This is a brand of split splice case product. It is an airtight, watertight, and self-contained housing for buried communications lines, such as telephone lines, comprising a main cable and service wires. This was used in the 1970s to date. Whoop around sleeve for RHM closure. This is a closure for a telecommunications splice case comprising of a wraparound sleeve secured, for example, by a rail and channel closure. It is a recoverable polymeric article for use as a wraparound sleeve having a first upstanding rail adjacent one edge thereof and a second upstanding rail space from another edge, such that the portion of material between the second rail and the other edge is a flap. It was invented by Dexter C. Tite Jr. in 1982 when the patent number 4436566 was filed in the US. The original assignee is RHM Corporation. Porcelain glass. Porcelain glass is used as an insulator and was first produced in the 1850s for use with telegraph lines. As technology developed, insulators were needed for telephone lines, electric power lines, and other applications. Porcelain Bakelite. Porcelain Bakelite is used on everything from power lines to telephone and telegraph lines insulators. It's made of phenol formaldehyde. It was introduced in the early 1900s. Porcelain insulator. Porcelain insulator is an insulator with the skirt made by a ceramic process. Wires are strung between poles, and insulators were used to keep the wires away from the poles. Insulators are at the root of a technology that is prevalent throughout the world today, although many people do not know what they are. The need for insulators began in the 1840s in response to the developing use of electricity and new forms of telecommunication. This was introduced in the late 1860s when Graham Bell invented the telephone. Spindle W-type. This has a W shape and it is used as a rotary spindle structure applied in housing, which includes two spindle lugs having a suspended resilient butt joint respectively. When a spindle rod is fixed in the spindle lugs, both end faces of the spindle rod bear against the resilient butt joint so that the resilient butt joints are forced to expand outwards till a pivot hole of the spindle rod is snapped with protruding walls of the spindle lugs, and thus the spindle rod is